The United States had big plans for the moon, and the Apollo program was just the start. As the public dreamt of a new home in the stars, NASA developed plans to make cosmic colonization a reality. The Apollo missions were laying the foundation for life on the lunar landscape. But just 3 years after the first landing, the United States ventured to the moon for the final time. In the 1960s, NASA was developing ambitious offshoots for the Apollo program, primarily the establishment of a moon base intended to extend humanity's time on the surface. The Lunar Shelter Laboratory, or SHELAB, was one of the concepts under consideration. SHELAB consisted of a cabin with an airlock chamber and a lunar excursion truck equipped with a flying belt for the astronauts. Powered by fuel cells and batteries, the shelter would support two astronauts for 14 days. It was believed that the lunar bases could be the start of a large, permanent colony on the moon. At the time, expanding on Apollo wasn't so far-fetched. The country's Cold War competition and desire to be first rapidly expanded the potential of space exploration. 2 years after NASA began operations, the US government allocated $500 million of the federal budget to the agency. In just 5 years, the budget grew to $5.2 billion, which represented 5.3% of all government spending. NASA expanded facilities across the country. The Manned Spacecraft Center in Houston, the Launch Operations Center at Cape Canaveral in Florida, and the Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama. With the rapid growth came hundreds of thousands of jobs. NASA's labor force peaked in the mid-60s with a reported 400,000 staffers and contractors. And the majority of NASA's resources went to the Apollo program. Between 1959 and 1973, the agency spent just over $23 billion on human spaceflight, of which nearly $20 billion was for Apollo. That amount of money today would equate to over $130 billion spent on one program alone. By the 1970s, public attention was no longer above the clouds. With the lunar landing achieved, attention shifted to the seemingly endless Vietnam War. And that's where government funds went as well, putting a huge strain on the US economy. NASA's glory years were starting to lose their grandiose glow. Budget cuts forced the agency to rethink the feasibility of its exploration plans. And since the Apollo program was expensive and risky, the agency's priorities started to move towards other projects. Ultimately, NASA decided to cut the Apollo program short. In 1970, the flights planned for Apollo 15, 19, and 20 were canceled, and the remaining missions were renumbered. The canceled missions freed up resources for NASA's Skylab and Space Shuttle, programs that were slated to launch over the next two decades. Some of the astronauts who spent years training for Apollo were reassigned to these programs, while others retired without ever making it to space. The Apollo 17 astronauts would be the last men to land on the moon. Veteran Gene Cernan would embark on his second lunar trek. During Apollo 10, he hovered above the surface, but this time, he'd get to touch down. The other moonwalker would be Jack Schmidt. He was the first scientist to be selected for an Apollo crew. And rookie Ronald Evans would man the command module while his crewmates journeyed to the moon. Apollo 17 launched on December 7, 1972. NASA selected the Taurus-Littrow region as the mission's landing location. The nearby Shorty crater was believed to hold evidence of past volcanic vents, and geologist-turned-astronaut Jack Schmidt would help provide vital insight of the area. En route to the moon, the astronauts got a view of home that had never been seen before. One of the astronauts grabbed a camera and snapped this picture. It's known as the Blue Marble, and it was the first photograph of the entire Earth taken by man. The picture became iconic and sparked a decades-long debate between the Apollo 17 crew members, each claiming that they were the photographer. After the snapshot, the crew made it to lunar orbit and eventually landed on the moon without major issue. The astronauts deployed scientific instruments and collected lunar samples, but at the end of their first trip in the lunar roving vehicle, they hit a problem.
There goes a fender. Oh, shoot.
Just like Apollo 13, this snag would be solved with duct tape. With the LRV running again, the team ventured to the rim of the Shorty crater, where they observed orange soil, which was later found to be tiny spheres of colored glass, likely from a volcanic vent. After about 3 days and a record 22 hours spent outside the lunar module, the astronauts prepared to head back to Earth for the last time.
America's challenge of today has forged man's destiny of tomorrow.
And with that, NASA's missions to the moon came to a close. The ambitious goals of the early Apollo program had fallen like dominoes, synchronized with NASA's depleting budget. The space agency moved on to other projects that would remain in low Earth orbit. Apollo 17 marked the world's last manned trip to another celestial body. But while the Apollo program came to an end, its contributions to science did not. And now, decades later, NASA is tracing a new path to the moon. The Apollo program revolutionized all aspects of space exploration. To learn more about the development of the first lunar vehicle, check out this video. Thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe.